the contestation was really, you know, increased dramatically when in 1997, in the fall of 1997, November, Eritrea introduced its own currency. Until then, they had used Ethiopian birr as their own currency, and it was a single monetary system. Now suddenly, and for very valid reasons, Eritrea wanted its own currency. It's important for a new state also to have the symbolic but nationalistic value of its own currency, called Nakfa, because of the historical importance of the city of Nakfa in North Eritrea. Ethiopia said, fair and well, you can have your currency, we will not stop you. But Eritrea wanted its currency to be on par with the birr, one-to-one, to follow the birr, to be locked to the birr, Ethiopian birr. Then Ethiopia said, no. If you introduce your own currency, it will be on your own terms. You should not link it on par with the Ethiopian birr. It has to fluctuate according to the Eritrean economic resource base. Eritrea said, no, we will introduce it and it will be on par with Ethiopian birr, you know. It did introduce it. Ethiopia, in a matter of a few weeks, produced a new birr, new Ethiopian birr, discarded the whole story of the old Ethiopian birr, saying that this is invalid because that was the birr that Eritrea had, and said that any kind of trade with Eritrea henceforth should be conducted in foreign currency or a credit of letter. We don't accept trade in local currency with Eritrea. That was suddenly imposed from one week to the other, and we still have images of trucks lining up. Hundreds of trucks on the Tigrayan side, Ethiopian side, wanted to enter into Eritrea, which was stopped from one day to the other, saying no. Where, you know, show us the letter of credit or the international currency exchange program for your goods. We don't allow trade with Eritrea anymore. This was very provocative, of course, on the Eritrean side, that Ethiopia should impose such restrictions. I was doing fieldwork in Asmara in the fall of 97 and talked to the trade minister myself, and he was going public encouraging Eritrean traders to violate Ethiopian imposed policies. Don't care about that. Continue trade in birr and not far. We don't care what they say about this. That was his official statement, November 1997. Then, what next? What happened? We have then reached a point where you have a kind of a merger, or you, at least you can see that these processes were building up towards a point where a confrontation might be unavoidable. The concrete issue when they imposed the trade regime was, where should we put our custom declaration form? Where is the border to put our custom office to do the paperwork for crossing the border? And then suddenly the border became extremely relevant from one day to the other, because it was not clear exactly which village or where the border was to be drawn, in a, particularly in the island at that time of Tigray border. We know that Eritrea started to prepare militarily from November, December 1997. They started to dig trenches in the highland area versus Ethiopia. And Ethiopia also suddenly started to prepare. One factor which I haven't told you is also the fact that you had clashes, military clashes, between TPLF army and Eritrean army in 97 in the lowland areas, Afar areas, which were at that time interpreted as kind of misunderstandings, and there were some letters of exchange between the two heads of states and said we have to clear this up, but later that has been interpreted as an expression of who has the control over what territory in the Afar area too. So it was also a military run-up to the conflict.